It was a sure enough honky-tonk, occupying the cellar of a saloon. It was the social center of what was then, and still is, Negro Harlem's kitchen.
Organ grinder. Organ grinder.
Here, a tall, brown-skinned girl, unmistakably the one guaranteed in the song to make a preacher lay his Bible down, used to sing and dance her own peculiar numbers, vesting them with their own originality. She was known simply as Ethel. Rudolph Fisher.
If you'll just cure my organ of those grinding blues.
Ethel Waters, one of the most influential of all American singers, was born in the red light district of Chester, Pennsylvania, the unwanted outcome of a rape. By the age of 10, she was the leader of a gang of children of every nationality who stole food to survive and acted as lookouts for the pimps and prostitutes in their neighborhood. God, Waters said later, made me tough, headstrong, and resilient. She began her musical career as a shimmy dancer and singer, billed as Sweet Mama Stringbean.
Positively, absolutely, sure was mine.
I sure knew how to roll and quiver, she remembered, and soon found herself appearing in black theaters and tent shows for $10 a week.
He shakes my ashes, greases my griddle, churns my butter, strokes my fiddle, my man.
Some of her records were in the bawdiest blues tradition. Organ Grinder Blues, Do What You Did Last Night, My Handyman. But unlike Bessie Smith and the other blues stars of her time, she had a light, clear voice and specialized in soft insinuation.
Music. I got my man, who could ask for anything more? I got Daisy.
In 1921, her manager insisted she try what he called white time, the all-white vaudeville circuit.
Old man trouble.
She was certain she would fail. I thought white people wouldn't understand my type of work, she recalled, and I wasn't going to change it.
I got sweet dreams.
But white people loved her. One critic hailed Waters as the greatest artist of her race and generation.
Days can be sunny.
She was singing popular songs now, the best songs from Tin Pan Alley's best songwriters, infusing them with the passion and artistry of the blues, bringing that hybrid sound to mainstream America for the first time.
I got my man who could ask for anything more. Old man trouble, I don't mind him. You won't find him round my door. I got starlight and I have sweet dreams. I got my man who could ask for anything more. Who could ask for anything more?
She made the transition from blues to popular songs. And she was able to take those songs and sing them in a way that was modern and important. They weren't torch songs when she did them. They weren't sentimental when she did them. They weren't flowery when she did them. And just to give you one instance of how the kind of impact she had, Sophie Tucker, who was considerably older and who was the queen of vaudeville, a great, great star, paid Ethel Waters money for singing lessons when Ethel was just in her 20s and just getting started. Because Sophie Tucker realized that the day was changing, and she better find out what this new singing is all about.
Waters' singing influenced nearly every kind of American popular music, and she became the first black woman to headline at the Palace in New York. She was, for a time, the best paid woman in show business, black or white, and had proven that it was possible for black singers to appeal to every kind of audience.
I'm just a woman, a lonely woman, waiting on weary shore.
In 1929, she went to Hollywood to appear in a film in which she sang Am I Blue, and utterly transcended the stereotyped plantation setting.
Woke up this morning along about dawn, without a warning.
Waters would be revered by generations of singers. Years later, Lena Horne paid her the highest possible compliment. Ethel Waters, she said, was the mother of us all.
Am I blue? Am I blue? My blue.